Book lovers, it's Jenny at Julia Baby Jen with my favorite historical reads from 2016. I have a very short list on this one. I didn't read as much historical this year as I'd hoped to, but I do have a few books to share with you. First, I have Walk on Earth, a Stranger by Ray Carson. It's hard to see, but oh, that cover is just gorgeous. Oh, just gorgeous. Okay, first of all, I'm a major Ray Carson fan. I love her writing, and I think at this point, well, no, I haven't read the new book in the series yet, but up to then, I've read every book she's written, and I've loved every single one. I've even read a novella she wrote, which was really good. I did get to meet her at the Tucson Book Festival last March. So I did get this baby sign. So yay. And actually, I was reading this while I was on vacation in Arizona, so that was kind of appropriate. Okay, so this is a story about Lee. This takes place during the Gold Rush. She lives in, I think it's Georgia is where she starts out from. So she lives in Georgia on a small little shanty with her parents. This is combined a little bit with fantasy because she has a magic ability to sense gold in the earth. Her parents have worked really hard to keep this a secret because obviously during the gold rush, people would kill to have this ability. Her parents are trying to protect her. Well, while she is gone one morning, she comes back and her parents are dead and have been murdered. And then her uncle shows up. And he has inherited everything because as a girl, she doesn't get anything. And he's the closest relative. And he is a terrible, terrible person. Basically, he knows about her gold ability. He's basically going to kidnap her and take her across country to California. And she's going to use her to find gold. She runs away and escapes from her uncle, disguises herself as a boy, and is on a pioneer wagon train to California during the gold rush. So most of this story is while she is on this wagon trail, and I am fascinated with pioneer things. I started with Laura Ingalls Wilder books when I was younger. I just think it's fascinating how our country was settled and what these people went through to settle it. I mean, the things that these people went through for a better life was incredible to me. We're so spoiled compared to those people. I mean, if you haven't learned anything about the pioneers of the wagon trail, I really suggest reading this book. You'll learn a lot. It was amazing. It's not super action-packed. There's a lot of, you know, not like the wagon trail was real fun all the time. It's a lot of boring, you know, monotonous journey, but there's lots of terrible things that happen. She has disguised herself as a boy and is hiding her ability. And so this is all about her journey across on this wagon trail. And it's just an amazing read, and I can't wait to read the sequel. Conspiracy of Blood and Smoke by Anne Blankman. This is actually the sequel to Prisoner of Night and Fog. This is a historical fiction book during World War II. It follows this girl named Gretchen, who lives in Germany, in Berlin. And actually, she was part of Adolf Hitler's inner circle. They were good. Her father was a good family friend of his. Father is dead. It's just her and her brother and her mother now. And the first book is all about her discovering exactly what's going on. This is like right before World War II. Discovering right what's really going on in her country and discovering exactly how evil Hitler is. So it's kind of a look at Hitler because she does it. I mean, there's scenes with him in the first book and it's very creepy. Obviously, it's fiction. She is based on a girl that was in his inner circle, but obviously a lot of, we're not going to know a lot of the details of these relationships. So this is fiction, but it's based off of a lot of fact and it was really interesting. So in this book, she's now on the run for her life. So this one got even more interesting to me. And I love World War II books, but this one was a really interesting look at the psychopath that is Hitler. And basically, that's what the first book is. It's discovering what psychopaths are, and specifically this particular psychopath. So it's a really good read. Very thrilling. I read The Bronze Horseman by Paulina Simons this year. This takes place during World War II as well in Leningrad during the Siege of Leningrad. This is actually a love story between Tatiana and Alexander. Tatiana is a normal girl who lives with her family in Leningrad. She meets Alexander. He's a soldier in the army. And he's actually dating her sister. She doesn't want to tear apart. She's like one of the sweetest people you've ever met and doesn't want to tear apart her sister and break her heart, even though her sister isn't really in love with Alexander and she is. So they hide their love and it's kind of their love story. But the most interesting thing about this book was the setting. It was horrific hearing what happened in Leningrad during that siege. I really don't know that much Russian history, and I really don't know a lot about what happened in Russia during World War II. We don't hear a lot about that. You hear a lot more what happened in Europe and what happened in the Pacific. But Russia was just as hard hit as anywhere else, if not more so. So this was very, very heart-wrenching, very good read. I really enjoyed it. And finally, I have Salt of the Sea by Rudi Sepetys, which was my favorite historical read of the year. I love Ruta's books. They're amazing. This is actually only the second one I've read. I read Out of the Easy last year and loved it so much. Well, I also met Ruta at the Tucson Book Festival, so that was pretty cool. So this is a signed book. This book had just come out when I went to it, so I was really happy that I got to meet her and get it signed. It says, "For Jenny, Freedom." So this is a really interesting story that also takes place during World War II. Place in the winter in 1945. It follows four different teenagers. They each have a secret, and we follow all four perspectives, and they're all very different, come from different walks of life, and all their paths kind of converge at the end of this. This is actually about one of the This is the single greatest tragedy in maritime history, and I don't think very many people know about it. I personally did not know about it. And it's about a terrible, terrible shipwreck that happened and killed more people than have ever been killed in maritime history in one single event. And like I said, nobody really knows about it. So this was an amazing story. What I loved about it was that all the chapters were very short. So you just kept wanting to keep going because you want to know what happened next. And it just flips between the four of them in each chapter. And it's so interesting. It's heartbreaking. It will stick with you for a really long time. It's one of the best books I've ever read on World War II, and I definitely recommend this one. You will learn so much because there's so much I learned reading this, and I know quite a bit about World War II. So yeah, this was an amazing, amazing read. And those are my favorite historical reads that I read in 2016. Historical fiction, I should say. Leave me any comments below what you read, if you read any good historical fiction. I love to get suggestions. And if you have any comments about any of these books, I'd love to hear those too. I hope everyone has a good day, and I will talk to you later. Bye.